storm that surrounds me. Just one word, the darkness has to retreat. Oh, just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes were open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that a God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that a God can't do. Just one word, you heal what's broken inside.
Many years ago, I was a farm manager come analyst, and one day I felt God speaking to me, you know, talking about the people in the street, people who are outcasts. He loves them as much as all of us, and God has been so good to me. I just want to bless them so that they could be in turn be a blessing to other people.
About a year ago in February, I was diagnosed with breast cancer. The thought of taking a break never crossed my mind, and as long as I have breath, my life is His.
I left my previous job because I felt God's calling to come and build His house.
I just felt the heart of God, you know, to reach out and just to do what Jesus did.
We didn't want to just sit back and complain. Yeah? We didn't want to be spectators anymore.
In being a part of World Vision, I feel that I'm able to be His hands and His feet to bring hope to those who need it most.
You're never too old to serve the Lord. I will continue to do God's work as long as I can walk and talk.
Part of the body of Christ, you should be using specific gifting that God has given you, so that, like in this orchestra, where everyone is playing a different musical instrument, what they are doing as a whole create a very wonderful symphony in the end. And that is what we ambition will happen in FGA Church.
For greater things, there's no power like the power of Jesus. So let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus. I will believe, come on. For greater things, there's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus. I will believe.
Hi, I'm Annabelle. I work as an administrative secretary in FGAKL. I primarily work with the young people in managing their day-to-day administrative work. I left my previous job because I felt God's calling for me to come and build His house. It's been a year so far, and it's been really exciting seeing how God has been moving among our young people. And it's my great honor to be a part of this great move and to serve even in a small way in God's house and doing administrative work for Him.
Darkness tries to roll over my bones. When sorrow comes to steal the joy I own. When brokenness and pain is all I know. Oh, I won't be shaken. No, I won't be shaken. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I
My name is Daphne Yap. I'm overseeing Seven Home Fellowship in Puchong area. And God has given me a burden to reach out to the community in Puchong. I remember in 2015, the Lord has given me this burden. Every Friday as I visit Home Fellowship, as I drive around and as I look into the community of Puchong, I just felt the heartbeat of God, you know, that God wants to actually reach out to the Puchong community. So I told God three things, you know, firstly, He need to give me a Puchong map. Secondly is, there's a hill that I can go and pray with my HF members. And then thirdly, it's to have a place that I can go in with my members to pray together. And true enough, the Lord has granted these three things to me. And that's where I felt I should go and speak to my pastors. We have done things like a blood donation drive. And also, we are looking into helping the poor and the needy in Puchong. In the spiritual side, we actually prayed and we will actually go to do prayer drive, you know, calling and asking God to pour forth His blessing over the community of Puchong. I just felt the heart of God, you know, to reach out and just to do what Jesus did, you know, to reach out and to impact the community of Puchong.
The one thing that I really learned about sharing Christ to my closest friends is you can be friends for many years, but you just know that you're keeping a certain secret
from them. And when you know that they need it so bad to know that there's this love, that why not you be the one to share to them?
I've been actively being part of sports ministry that I've engaged some of my friends from the marketplace to actually be part of. It all started with the heart for people and getting them connected to a bond where they can find a sense of support or even building friendship.
God's love is the main thing. God's love put into action, and we are nobody, just normal people, and just go there with bare hands and do what we can. Yeah.
Many a times we don't know how God works, and sometimes we sow, but we will not see any result. So we believe, keep sowing, never give up. We might not see the harvest. Somebody along the line God will send to do the harvest.
How I developed the heart for people is knowing that their life is precious in God's eyes.
I think one of the most important things is the love and care.
As stated in the Bible, that our God is unceasing loving us, and we too unceasingly loving someone which is out of our comfort zone. Yeah?
It's important how we reach out to others. If they can't feel or if they can't experience the love that is in you, there's not much point for us to tell them about our God's love.
I believe we should never give up sharing God's love, intentionally obeying the Great Commission.
Our lives have been transformed because someone showed love to us, someone shared Christ with us, and change our lives.
Hi, I'm Alvin from MTTE, that is the Ministry to the Elderly.
Yeah, I'm Maggie from the same ministry.
I believe we should never give up sharing God's love, intentionally obeying the Great Commission. Because we are dealing with all the elderly, we don't know whether they will still be around tomorrow.
Yeah, actually, I think it's quite urgent because because they are aging. And then so often when we go there, we may see them this month. The next month, if we go, we may not see them anymore. So the urgency is that we want to show God's love with them. At least they know Jesus before they leave the world.
We spend a lot of time talking to these elderly because they are quite lonely. So these are the people that need someone to talk to. And they like to talk and tell us their past. They like to tell us about their family, how many grandchildren they have, and their glorious days. I can recall this one lady, we call her Famola, that's her nickname. We started sharing the gospel with her after initially knowing her, talk to her, find out family and all those things. Then when we asked her whether she wanted to receive Jesus as her personal Lord and Savior, she sternly said no. One day when we visited the home again, she wasn't there. When we were introduced to a new home, we went there, and there she was. Similarly, after a few years, she disappeared. When we found a new home, and there she was again. So we bumped into her three times, three different homes. Continue to show our love with her, to her, and continue to share with her the gospel and tell her this time that God is really serious, pursuing you seriously. See, out of so many homes, we bumped each other again. So in the end, one fine day, she found out that she had a brain tumor, and she was quite ill, and she was kind of helpless and also hopeless. And when we shared the gospel with her that time, she relented. She said yes, and we led her to the Lord. And a few months, how long?
Few months later.
Few months down the line, she passed on. So to us, she managed to go on to the last train, the last station. And we know for sure she's now with God, because we believe the promise of God that whoever call on His name, confess and believe in Him will be saved.
But most important, as we go, we show our love, our care to them.
Where could I run that you wouldn't run after me? How could I fall when you are here?
Hi, my name is Edwin Chia. I've been involved in the Orang Asli Ministry in Broga, Semenye. One of the things I learned is to be constantly present, show love and care for the Orang Asli kids. We are nobody, just normal people, and just go there with bare hands and do what we can. Yeah. The children inside there, they literally thought, what are we doing? Why you constantly come over? Why? Of course, the key is to love you. And of course, they will puzzle, but years later, they start to open up. They start to share many stuffs in their kampung, what's happening, this and that. Of course, now we are the 6 years in there, and practically we are like buddies. We know each other well. I believe that our character have actually touched them, and they too felt our love, Christ's love. One of the things I experienced, when I step out, I get to see God at work. Someone told me, Orang Asli Ministry is an uphill task. I remember that very well. It is actually. But we imagine if we do not go there, and what will happen to them? If you know, after all we learn in FGA Church, it's a great church. So many lessons we have learned, but we do not output into action, then it's sort of like, did not put into use. God's love is the main thing. God's love put into action.
Morning Church, welcome to our first service of the year 2021. Indeed, it's a great time to worship God this morning. Now, this morning, we are also having our Holy Communion. So if you have not prepared your emblems, you can go ahead and prepare your emblems. We want to worship God this morning. We want to worship Him with all our spirit as we look forward to God bringing us a great year this morning. You know, we want to, if you're on the online platform, why don't you just, greet one another and say what you're looking forward to. We're looking for a great year this year. Yeah, let's open with a word of prayer and trust that God will lead us through this year, bringing us to a time of faithfulness. Father Lord, we want to thank You that You are a God who has been watching over us the whole of last year. And as we begin this year, Lord, we know that You will continue to be with us, that You will continue to be faithful, that You will continue to guide us, Lord God, in all that we do. And we look to a wonderful year this year, Lord God, and we look to You, Lord God, to bring us all that joy, that hope, and the greatness, Lord God. So we want to pray, Lord God, and worship You this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, church, let's worship God with all our spirit and truth this morning, even as we begin the year 2020.
Good morning, FGA, and a happy new year to you. Welcome to the year 2021. And as we usher this new year, we just want to give thanks to the Lord for His goodness and also trust and lean on His amazing grace throughout the year ahead. So I just want to read a scripture to you this morning. Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Let them say among the nations, the Lord reigns. Let the sea resound and all that is in it. Let the fields be jubilant and everything in them. Let the trees and forests sing. Let them sing for joy before the Lord, for He comes to judge the earth. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good and His love endures forever. Come on, let us worship Him this morning.
Your goodness never stops, Your mercy Thank you.
nations with truth and justice shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love that you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. Yeah.
unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross, you would lay down your life, that I would be set free. You've done for me.
Indeed, we serve an amazing God, a God who truly loves us, and we stand in awe in His presence. Now, this morning, even as we prepare ourselves to partake of the first Holy Communion as a church, let's search our hearts. Let's search our hearts and see if there are things that is not right with God. Now let's take this short moment of time and just look to God and say, God, if I've not been perfect, there are things that I've done that is wrong, and I seek your forgiveness right now, Lord. Let God search our hearts this morning. Now even as we prepare to partake, we are going to partake to remember the love that Christ showed for each and every one of us. The love that put Him onto that cross. And as we partake, that we will remember that this love is not just for us, but for all to share and all to know. Why don't we just hold the emblem in our hands this morning, even as we give thanks to our Lord Jesus Christ for His love that He's shown us. Dear Lord Jesus, we want to thank You for Your love. Your love that kept You nailed to that cross. Your love that allowed Your body to be bruised and broken for each and every one of us. And we pray that even as we partake of this bread together as a church, that we will continue to remember of this love and to share it as well, Lord God. On the night Jesus was betrayed, He took bread. And when He had given thanks, and He broke it, and He said, "This is My body for you. Do this in remembrance of Me." Let's partake of the bread together. Let us hold a cup. The cup that symbolizes the blood of Christ that was shed for each and every one of us. Let's give thanks to Christ for His blood that was shed for us. Dear Lord Jesus, we want to thank You once again for Your love. That You allowed Yourself to be pierced, You allowed Your blood to be flowed out, so that through Your blood, Lord God, that we may be cleansed, that we may be made whole, so that we can partake of eternal life with You, Lord God. We thank You, Lord God, for Your love. In the same way, after supper, He took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in My blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of Me." Let's partake of the cup together. Once again, I want to thank You, Lord, for Your body and Your blood, which was broken and shed for each and every one of us. And we pray, Lord God, even as we continue to partake of this Holy Communion as a church, that we will remember of Your love and that we will share this love with all those around us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Father, we pray for Your blessings and favor, Lord, to be upon us as we enter into this new year, Lord. May Your anointing and Your presence follow us throughout this year and all the days of our lives. As we sing this song, Lord, we just want to proclaim Your blessing over us, Lord, over our families and over our children, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, oh, we worship You, Lord. Lord bless.
Oh, behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He's with you,
He's with you.
In the morning,
in the evening,
in your coming and your going, in your weeping and rejoicing, He is for you. He is for you. He is for you. He is for you.
Amen, amen, and amen. Now, even as we begin the year, I'd like to pray for God's blessing, for our commitment to God in this new year, 2021. Now, even as we say this prayer this morning, why don't you just put your hand on your heart this morning, even as we dedicate our lives unto God, even as we begin this year, let us begin it right with God. Ephesians 5, verse 15 to 17 says, "Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is." Let's pray together. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we look to you as we enter the new year 2021 in an apprehensive world that is grappling still with uncertainties. We find our assurance in your promise that your presence will be with us as we face all that lies ahead. May we make conscious choice to remain in you, surrendering our self-will to you each day. Help us to fear you so that we will walk wisely in this dark world. Grant us your insight and grace to make the most of every opportunity to live and work for your glory. Constantly remind us, O God, that we are sojourners in this world and to set our minds on things above. May we also avoid escapist mindset that distracts us from our responsibilities to be salt and light to both society and nation. Cause us to examine our own life constantly, carrying within us the due sober judgments towards our own selves, that we may be found living rightly in your sight. Father, we commit to you our individual lives, hopes, and concerns for 2021, trusting in you alone to carry us through. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Now, Father, right now I just want to pray if you have a need. You know, even as we begin this year, if you have a need and you want to lay it unto God this morning, why don't you just, wherever you are, just raise your hands and say, God, I surrender this need unto you. I surrender this issue unto you. I surrender this illness unto you. You know, as we raise our hands, we cry out unto God in your own ways, because God hears us. Let's pray. Father Lord, you see all the hands that are raised across the homes, wherever they are. You know their every need. You know their every struggle. You know their every sickness. You know their every circumstances. And right now, Lord God, we pray for your Holy Spirit just to fall upon them, wherever they are. Touch them right now. Touch them right now, Lord God. And that you will start to pull them out of their circumstances. You pull them out of all their struggles. You pull them out of all their difficulties. You pull them out of all their sickness right now. Pour out your love. Pour out your providence. Pour out your healing upon them. Touch them at their point of need right now. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. We want to continue to remain in this attitude of worship this morning as we come to a time of giving of our tithes and offering. We can continue to give our tithes and offering through two methods. The first is to give unto to bank in directly into our church account. The number is on the screen. And also, if you are in the online platform, you can click on the give button and it will bring you to all the necessary details. The other way is you can also give to our Touch and Go app. Just scan the QR code and enter your payment and your PIN. Now let's pray. Father, we thank you that you have always been faithful to us throughout 2020, and even as we move in 2021, we know that you will continue to be with us, providing for us in all our needs. And we pray, Lord God, that even as we come to this time of giving, we pray for that heart of obedience to be upon us, Lord God, that we will give for your glory, for your name, for your kingdom, oh Lord God. And we pray that everything that we give will be used for the extension of your kingdom and to meet the needs of your people, oh Lord God. Come, oh Lord God, come and touch our hearts even as we give, and use it for your extension of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Now, this year we begin our first service with a message from our chairman elder, Elder Liew Hoi Fu.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Morning, FGA. Welcome back to 2021, this new year. On behalf of the church, the elders, and the leadership, I'd like to wish you a very happy new year, 2021, a joyous, fruitful new year that the Lord God will provide for your needs. As we go forth in this new year, let us come before the Lord this morning. Let's commit this time to the Lord. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debt as we have forgiven our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is thy kingdom, thy power, and thy glory, forever and evermore. Amen. Our Father, we thank you that, Lord, we can begin this new year by coming before you, committing ourselves, surrendering ourselves, submitting ourselves to your Lordship and your Lordship alone. So, Lord, we invite you to be with us this morning. We ask your presence to be with us wherever we are, in our homes, where we are now gathered together as a family, or if we are single, we are gathered alone. But, Lord, we know your presence shall be with us, that as we begin this new year, Lord, we want to begin by inviting you into our hearts once again to be our Lord and Savior, our Master. Lord, we thank you. Lord Jesus, we thank you that you are our Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we have not met for nearly a year. We last met in March 2020, and now is a new year. And as we begin this new year, all right, we always look forward to what God has for us as a church, what direction God wants to give us. And this morning, I would like to ask you to come with me as we read a passage from Haggai, a reading from chapter 1 through to chapter 2, verse 9. Now, the book of Haggai, a call to build the house of the Lord. In the second year of King Darius, on the first day of the sixth month, the word of the Lord came through the prophet Haggai to Zerubbabel, son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and to Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest. This is what the Lord Almighty says. These people say, the time has not yet come for the Lord's house to be built. Then the word of the Lord came through the prophet Haggai. Is it a time for you yourselves to be living in your panel houses while this house remains a ruin? Now this is what the Lord Almighty says. Give careful thought to your ways. You have planted much, but have harvested little. You eat, but never have enough. You drink, but never have your fill. You put your clothes, but are not warm. You earn wages, only to put them in a purse with holes in it. This is what the Lord Almighty says. Give careful thoughts to your ways. Go up into the mountains and bring down timber and build the house, so that I may take pleasure in it and be honored, says the Lord. You expected much, but see, it turned out to be little. What you brought home, I blew away. Why? Declares the Lord Almighty. Because of my house which remains a ruin, while each of you is busy with his own house. Therefore, because of you, the heavens have withheld their dew, and the earth its crops. I call for a drought on the fields and the mountains, on the grains, the new wine, the oil, and whatever the ground produces, on men and cattle, and on the labor of your hands. Then Zerubbabel, son of Shealtiel, Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest, and the whole remnant of the people obey the voice of the Lord their God and the message of the prophet Haggai, because the Lord their God has sent him, and the people feared the Lord. Then Haggai, the Lord's messenger, gave this message of the Lord to the people. I am with you, declares the Lord. So the Lord stirred up the spirit of Zerubbabel, son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and the spirit of Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest, and the spirit of the whole remnant of the people. They came and began work on the house of the Lord Almighty, their God, on the 24th day of the sixth month in the second year of King Darius. On the 21st day of the seventh month, the word of the Lord came through the prophet Haggai. Speak to Zerubbabel, son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, to Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest, and to the remnant of the people. Ask them, who of you is left who saw this house in its former glory? How does it look to you now? Does it not seem to you like nothing? But now be strong, O Zerubbabel, declared the Lord. Be strong, O Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest. Be strong, all you people of the land, declares the Lord, and work. For I am with you, declares the Lord Almighty. This is what I covenanted with you when you came out of Egypt. And my spirit remains among you. Do not fear. This is what the Lord Almighty says. In a little while, I will once more shake the heavens and the earth, the sea and the dry land. I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations will come, and I will fill this house with glory, says the Lord Almighty. The silver is mine, the gold is mine, declares the Lord Almighty. The glory of this present house will be greater than the glory of the former house, says the Lord Almighty. And in this house I will grant peace, declares the Lord Almighty. Praise God for the reading of His word. So as we begin this new year, as you can see, God has spoken to the exiles who have returned to Israel to rebuild the house of the Lord. The exiles from the land of captivity returned to Jerusalem, and their purpose for coming back and returning is with a good purpose, with a view to rebuild the temple. With noble and unselfish enthusiasm, they began the work. But as usual, faith of great enthusiasm soon wears them out. Hard practical realities of life came its way, and work was suspended. A handful remained true to the original ideas and intention and purpose of coming back to Jerusalem. The rest fell away. They fell away because they have gone into their personal comfort, their domestic life, their greed, and so forth. All this sets in as they began to rebuild the temple. Like every great cause, when it was launched amidst high hopes and honest zeal, practical things sets in, but the degree of hopes faded into just godly imagination. Came with great ideas, great purpose, but when practical issues crops in, life challenges comes in, soon the purpose becomes just an imagination. Exiles took to building their own houses, let the house of God lay in waste. They began to think more of settling down in the land instead of building the temple. As practical men, they are thinking of providing for their families, thinking of their businesses, and thinking of the future, and have neglected their sole purpose of coming back. The main purpose of coming back is to rebuild the temple. Their wisdom, worldly wisdom, turned out to be a folly. A season of distress came in. Their harvest failed. They became poor. They were hungry. And once again, they turned back to the Lord. Now, calamity has struck them, and this caused them to urge them to come back to the Lord and fulfill their original purpose. Their first purpose, of course, is to serve the Lord and obey and live with Him. Now, we have gone through 10 months not being able to meet together, and in a new setting, economic environment that we have never experienced before. While we are free, we are not free. We are able to move around and yet restricted. And many face severe challenges in putting food on the table for the family, in their businesses. All the negativity has surrounded us. Just like the days of old, what are we going to do? Now, God has reminded us today, yes, such negativity is around, such economic challenges is around, but we must not lose our focus, our purpose. That is to serve the Lord first. In Matthew 6 verse 33, we are reminded, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness first, and all these things shall be added unto you. But if we look at the second part first and forget about seeking the Lord first, as what happened to these exiles who came back to Jerusalem, they got distracted and then they left the temple to ruin again. And God has warned them, to remind them to come back, for whatever they are planted, right? He says, you are planted much, but harvested little. Now, how is that so? We in Malaysia, we know we have many plantations, and palm oil is one of our big export earners. Those who are in the palm oil estate, palm oil industries, will realize that not every plantation, not every estate are able to produce the same kind of yield. All right? The yield per acre is very dependent on the weather, on the conditions that are around them, and the time and season of the year. So you may have a large acreage of palm oil, but your yield can be very low and your harvest will be very little compared to someone whose estate is much smaller and yet have higher yield. Now, this is what God is trying to remind us in this new year. All right? We may plant much, we may do a lot of things, but our harvest is going to be little. Both in our daily lives and also in our spiritual life. If we neglect our spiritual life, we can plant much in our daily life. We can pursue, right, our career, our work, our businesses, right? We look after them. We provide for our family. All these are good things. They are not bad. But we start to neglect our spiritual life, then the result is going to be very, very bad. As has been seen here, the exiles who were in captivity excitedly came back to Jerusalem and being commanded, they started rebuilding the temple. Unfortunately, having begun, their enthusiasm went away. They wear them out and they start looking at their own life. They start looking at their own homes. All right? Instead of rebuilding the temple, they began to build beautiful homes, panel houses, and they come into their own comfort way. And they lost track. And can easily be caught up and to be so busy that there's no time for God. And God is now put into a corner of our life that soon will be neglected. Just as the last 10 months have gone by, we have heard of many who in the change in our environment, the economic environment, Sunday service is no longer a disciplined time to come to church. Church is any time of the day when they find the time to switch on and go on to the online message that has been uploaded. It's no longer coming together at 9:30 for us, right, in the first service. But any time of the day is church service. Now, this is what has happened. We have allowed the world to come to us again and let our own private lives overtaken our purpose. Sunday is a day of rest. God has made it the Sabbath, a day of rest for all of us so that we have time to come together and worship the Lord. Though we are now separated, we are not able to gather in church, but technology has made it possible for us to gather in our respective home as a family. Very often we ask, oh, why don't we have a family Sunday so that we can gather in a family? Now, every Sunday is family Sunday now. We can gather as a family and we come together to worship. And we praise be to God that in FGA we are so privileged. If you are children, you will know that the children ministry runs the Sunday children programs for the toddlers, for the preschoolers, and for the primary school. And I can see because my grandchildren get very excited and they fall into these three categories. And they look forward and I can see them enjoying it, coming together. And the parents excitedly getting ready to sign them on at the time that's allotted. That's wonderful. That Lord, we are raising up our children in the way of the Lord, that they will not lose sight to put God first. As they grow up, they will remember their childhood days, how it was like on the Sunday. Now, as a result of these challenges that we have faced over the last 10 months, we may end up, some may end up, not all, as I said here in Haggai, there were still remnants who were keep true to their original purpose of coming back to rebuild. But the rest has fallen away. Now, it is quite easy for us to fall away into godlessness because of the challenges that we are facing before us. And in this new year, we don't know what is ahead of us. But we have been reminded in Matthew 6:33 that if we put God first, the secondary things will fall into place. God's promise never fails. And we know that it is fruitless if we decide to work the way of the world. Just as it is stated here, you have planted much, harvested little, and then it says that you eat but never have enough. You drink, but not have your fill. And you put on clothes, but not warm. You earn wages only to put them in a purse with holes in it. Now, obviously, we don't keep purses with holes. What it means to us is we can go our way, we can climb the ladder in our career to the top, we can run our businesses that we are so successful in the eyes of the world. But at the end of the day, all right, as in Proverbs it says, you know, surely, all right, riches will sprout wings and fly away. Now that is found in Proverbs. We are reminded to be very, very careful in Proverbs 23, all right, our riches can fly a glance and it disappears. Look at the meltdown that has happened. Those who are invested will find that so many businesses over the last 10 months have closed down. Look at the restaurants. Look at the shops. Look at the malls. So many empty vacant lots. Look at the property owners. Once upon a time, if you own a mall, you own an office building, you consider yourself to be very, very rich. But today, you face a big problem. Empty offices, empty mall. But the maintenance is still there. All right? Maintenance is still there. So, all our toil has become fruitless to us. Isn't it? That you have planted much and harvested little now? Look at that. I mean, you have done all that you can to put on a nice mall, a nice building, run your businesses, and suddenly this pandemic came along and next, your business has gone down the drain. I have seen restaurants who do not know what to do. They have rental to pay, their wages to pay, but no customers. Customers just shy away through no fault of theirs. The situation is not something that is within their control. So what do we do? God reminded us to put Him first, that God in such situation, as you can see, businesses have now turned into online, restaurants have turned into online, that instead of waiting for customers to come, they offer their business on the net, that it will be delivered to their home. Meals will be delivered to your home. I think many of us have experienced this. And there's a boom in the business of the Grab drivers and deliveries, because now they suddenly have so many orders. See, what is one man's loss is another man's gain here. So, if you know the story of Grab, Grab, the owner, the founders, are believers. They started this business, but they are believers. They were trusted God because they have been running at a loss. But as a result of this current pandemic, their business has boomed. Many who have not thought of how it's going to be have found a new way. So, as in this, we are reminded that the little that we have, if we store up treasures for ourselves, all right? Jesus says we should store up our treasures in heaven, not on earth, where moth will come and eat. And remember the story of the parable of the rich fool. He store up, and God says, what if your life is demanded of you tonight? Where will your riches be? We can be successful and not put God aside. We want to put God first and let God lead us into this 2021, this new year. It's not easy. These days, we don't hear of banks closing down. But in the 80s, you will remember the older ones. Many were placed their money in the high interest deposit companies. The companies closed down. Whatever little saving they have has disappeared. The wages, the little they save and they put into the deposit taking company, and overnight it disappeared. It's just like what is said here by the prophet Haggai, that you earn wages only to put them in purse with holes in it. It is like that. If you are not careful, in this new year, as we go forward, we will end up like the exiles who came back, lost their purpose. But praise be to God, because in the second part, God called the people back, gave a warning, and the people believed what God says and repented. And in Haggai chapter 2, verse 2 to 9, let me read to you. On the 21st day of the seventh month, the word of the Lord came through the prophet Haggai. Speak to Zerubbabel, son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, to Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest, and to the remnants of the people. Ask them, who of you is left who saw this house in its former glory? How does it look to you now? Does it not seem to you like nothing? But now be strong, O Zerubbabel, declares the Lord. Be strong, O Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest. Be strong, all you people of the land, declares the Lord, and work, for I am with you, declares the Lord Almighty. This is what I covenanted with you when you came out of Egypt, and my spirit remains among you. Do not fear. This is what the Lord Almighty says. In a little while, I will once more shake the heavens and the earth, the sea and the dry land. I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations will come, and I will fill this house with glory, says the Lord Almighty. The silver is mine, the gold is mine, declares the Lord Almighty. The glory of this present house will be greater than the glory of the former house, says the Lord Almighty. And in this place I will grant peace, declares the Lord Almighty. As we return to the Lord, as we put God first, God promises us He will grant us peace. And He is with us, reminding us not to be fearful, for He has said, do not fear. We go into unknown in 2021, but God is with us, because He says that here, when the exiles came out of Egypt, He has been with them and He's still with them. And God is with us in this new year, 2021. We may face new challenges. Let us stay focused in abiding in the Lord. For He says, the Lord God Almighty is the vine. We are the branch. And we can only be fruitful if we abide in the vine, that we be fruitful branches. There may be pruning along the way. Yes, pruning can be painful, but it will result in fruitfulness. We face challenges in this uncertain time, in this new year. Let us not despair. Let us not worry unnecessarily. Yes, it's going to be a challenge. We don't know where we'll be heading economically as a nation and as a world, for this is too vast an issue, an economic issue. It's beyond, I think, any one of us. All right, economists may predict, but God says He's going to shake once more desires of nations that are in trade war. We will focus on the Lord, and He will provide, as we are reminded in Matthew 6:33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. So my brothers and sisters, let us come back to the Lord. Let us in this new year come before Him, surrendering ourselves unto Him, submitting to Him and Him alone, and depend on Him and not in the ways that we have thought of, the worldly wisdom, but godly wisdom from on high, the wisdom of God. For He says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. So let us begin this new year 2021 by fearing the Lord God Almighty, to receive His wisdom and understanding in going forward in this new year 2021. And as a church, God has given us this mandate of M100. Many in 2020 have brought forth a mighty harvest. We have heard of wonderful, wonderful harvest of salvation. And praise be to God. We thank all our brothers and sisters who have worked untiringly using new ways, not being able to meet in church, but through new technology, reaching out that we have so many salvation, and there were also many baptisms that have been reported. And we praise be to God that in this new year, we will continue to have mighty harvest, that we have not only planted much and harvested little, but we shall harvest much, as the Lord says, as we put Him first, as we continue to rebuild the temple of God in our life, as we rebuild the temple of God in our spiritual lives. God is with us. Do not fear. That do not fear the unknown in 2021, for God is with us, and He will see us through 2021 victoriously. So my brothers and sisters, wherever you are now, can I invite you to stand with me or if you like, you can sit, you kneel. Let us surrender our lives once again back to God and let God lead us into this new year. Shall we pray? Father God, we come before you, O Lord, that in this new year we want to surrender our lives back to you, Lord. Lord Jesus, we invite you into our life to be our Lord, our Master, our Savior. Apart from you, we have no other. And Holy Spirit, come and dwell in us to be our counselor and our comforter. And Lord God Almighty, you are our Abba Father. We look up unto you, Abba Father, for thy provisions, that in this new year we turn not to the left or to the right, but we look up unto you and you alone. And Lord, help us to stay focused. And Lord, make us into your salt and light and witnesses to fulfill the mandate of M100 that you have given unto us through your church, FGA. We want to be a part of this glorious new church, for the latter house shall be greater than the former house, and this new year shall be greater than last year and the years before. For Lord, we put our trust in your unfailing love to you and you alone, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And now, in this new year, if you have not received the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let me open this time to you. As you can see on the screen, you can click and you can call, that our counselors will reach out to you as you reply, right? Touch the button, click, and we shall come with, together with you and lead you through a sinner's prayer. And in this new year, you can be a child of God. For the Word of God says, our Lord Jesus came to seek and save which that has been lost, and whoever believes in him shall have eternal life. And therefore, this morning, in this new year, wherever you are, if you have not received Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, you can do it now. And I will encourage that you receive him now, for this is the time in this new year God wants to bless you. And now, may I pray for each and every one of you as we close. Father God, we thank you for reminding us to rebuild your house, to put you first, that we will not put on our own worldly wisdom, but the wisdom from on high, from you and you alone. So Lord, as we go forth now, O God, the Lord, you keep us and bless us. You make your face shine upon us and be gracious unto us. You turn your face toward us and grant us peace. This, O God, we give you thanks as you dismiss us this morning, as we go forth now. Lord, we thank you that you are with us and we will not be afraid, that your presence is with us. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.